In this video, we will be discussing about the types of elasticity. So there are different degrees to which the demand responds due to a change in price. And accordingly, the types of elasticity develops. So case number one. Now what I have written over here, suppose check here the law of demand is operating. With price rise there has been reduction in demand and with price fall there has been increase of demand. But due to a small price change, due to a small percentage change in price, the demand has dropped to as low as zero. So this is a very abnormal condition due to a small price change. Suppose from 2 to 3 it became, the entire demand is dropping to 0. And due to a small drop in price, from suppose 2 rupees the product is becoming 1 rupee, there has been so much increase in demand, so high as it has reached infinity. So this is very unusual case or rare case when it happens. So demand is highly elastic, we even call it perfectly elastic, too much stretchable on either side, perfectly elastic. Because of small price rise, the percentage change in price is very small, but in response to that, the quantity demand has dropped to zero. So the demand is highly elastic. Similarly, due to a small change in price, downward shift of price, demand have increased following the law, but it has increased to very high level that it reaches infinity. So both shows that demand is very elastic in this case. Now how to get the value of elasticity? So the measurement of elasticity was percentage change in quantity demanded by percentage change in price. Now here the percentage change in demand, whether it is going down or going up, it is very huge. So we call it infinite change in the demand. And due to a small change in price, so let us assume that the change in price is 5%, a very small change in price, or you can also take 2%, a small change in price have resulted in infinite change in the demand, and infinity by anything will give you back the result infinity. So elasticity's value, price elasticity of demand's value for perfect elastic demand is always infinity. And how the graph looks like? There exists only one price at which you can sell or you can demand any amount of quantity. Somebody demands less, somebody demands more, but at this price. Why? Because a small increase in price, what will happen? The demand falls to zero. So you cannot even get a demand curve. And a small reduction in price, the demand touches infinite. Infinity cannot be drawn and shown. It cannot be achieved, the curve cannot be drawn. So a small change in price upward than this will result in fall of demand to zero, whereas a small drop in price will result in demand rising to infinite, which we cannot draw. So the curve will look like a straight horizontal line parallel to the x-axis in case of perfectly elastic demand. So at only at this price there can be any number of quantity which the consumers can demand, and the value of EP in this case is infinite. The next type of elasticity, case 2,
is elastic. Not perfectly elastic, but elastic. Now, when we call demand to be elastic, with price increase, if the quantity demand decreases
and the change in demand is much more than the price change. So here you can see that the law is operating. Due to price rise, quantity demand is falling, and due to price fall, quantity demand is rising. But how the demand is responsive in relation to price? Price increases slightly, but demand drops down much more. Here price decreases, demand goes up much more. So in compared to change in price, the change in demand is much more. But if you compare with the previous case, perfectly elastic, the demand is going down, but it is not dropping to zero. Similarly, the demand is going up. Maybe the change in demand is much more than price, but it is not touching infinity. So, how to derive the elasticity value? So, elasticity can be measured in percentage change in price, demand by change in price. So, here, from the example, you can understand the demand is not changing infinitely. It is not dropping to zero or reaching infinity. But the change of demand is more than that of price. That is understandable. So if the change in quantity demand is by 10% and the change in price, let it be 5%. So more is the change in demand in respect to price. Percentage sign gets cancelled. EP is a pure ratio, unit free number, 5 twos are 10. So elasticity will be 2. So whenever the value of elasticity is greater than 1, 2 is greater than 1, we call that demand is elastic. And how the curve looks like? In this case, you need to follow two things. How the price and quantity is changing. Price change is slightly happening and quantity demand responds by much more amount. So suppose if this is P1 and the relation between price and quantity is still inverse. At P1, suppose you demand Q1 units of the commodity. Now when P increases slightly, P2, so the increase is slight. And the demand will fall off, but demand falls by much more amount. So now, this is Q2. And if P again increases slight, then also the demand falls by much more. So the negative relation between P and Q is still present over here, as given by the law. With P lesser, you demand more, and with P as increasing, you demand less. But how much price is increasing lesser and by less amounts, but quantity is decreasing more than the change in price. So if you plot this, you will get a gentle or a flat downward sloping demand curve. So for elastic demand, the elasticity's value is greater than 1 and the demand curve looks gentle, not steep. It is a downward sloping straight line having a very gentle slope. And the next types we will be doing in the next video.